Hello everyone and welcome to Van Tech Corner. In this video, let's take a look at the NanoPi R5S from FriendlyWRT and set up a working internet connection with this router. The NanoPi R5S can be considered as the successor of the NanoPi R4S. It is powered by the Rockchip RK3568B2 SoC with 4 cores and the clock can go up to 2 GHz. The R5S had 2 models with 2 GB and 4 GB of LPDDR4x RAM. Regardless of the model, you will have 8 GB onboard eMMC storage to install the OS. What makes this router stand out is the 2 2.5 Gb network port and the M.2 NVME slot. Unlike the R4S, which can only be used in headless mode, the R5S is now having an HDMI port for video output. Besides, you will have 2 USB 3.0 Gen 1 ports to connect external devices. You can also purchase the R5S with a custom CNC casing that were carefully designed by FriendlyWRT. The case is solid and it provides passive cooling and protection to the board inside. Now, let's take a closer look at the R4S I/Os and connectors. There are 3 network ports at the back, 2 2.5 Gigabit Ethernet ports with LAN 1 and LAN 2 labeled, and 1 Gigabit Ethernet port with 1 label. Next to it is the HDMI port to connect monitors and the USB Type-C port to power on the board. The port supports PD 5, 9 and 12 volt. They also a spare hole just in case you want to add a wireless antennas in the future. The LED indicators and the 2 USB 3.0 ports are located at the front side. You will have 1 LED indicating system status, 1 LED indicating WAN activity, and 2 LED indicating LAN 1 and LAN 2's activity. As usual, there is a micro SD card slot on the rear side. Even though the OS is installed into the eMMC storage, we may need the micro SD card to boot up the OS in some cases. On the other side, there is a button with mask label. This button will be used to turn the R4S into mask room mode for firmware installations or debug purposes. Now, let's open the case to access the M.2 slot and the internal connector. This is very simple. You just need to unscrew 4 screws at the bottom of the case, and that's it. We can see the M.2 NVMe slot as well as the FriendlyWRT NanoPi R5S text printed on the PCB. Let's remove the 4 small screws to completely take out the board. Here is the RK3568B2 SoC. Next to it is a 2 GB RAM chip from Ryzen. Something new on the R5S is the SDIO I2S connector for external audio output, 2 1.25mm pins for real-time clock battery, and the 12-pin GVL connector. The rest remains the same with R4S, including the fan connectors and the unpopulated debug UART pins. Next to its Ethernet port, there will be an Ethernet controller chip. There are 2 Realtek RTL's A125GB chip for the 2 2.5 Gb Ethernet ports, and the Realtek RTL A211F for the 1 Gb Ethernet port. At the back of the PCB, there is the 8 GB eMMC chip as well as the pin for the SPI flash chip. Now, let's connect the Ethernet cable to the LAN port and the WAN port, and then powering on the board with a USB Type-C power adapter. Very good. We can see the link speed of the network interface is 2.5 gigabit. Now, let's assess the R5S LuCI interface as 192.168.2.1. The username is root and the default password is password. The router is pre-installed with FriendlyWRT, a fork of OpenWRT that was developed by the Friendly Elect or the NanoPi team. It is running to OpenWRT version 22.03RC2 and having kernel version 5.10.66. This is the 2GB RAM version, so I have 1.92GB of memory and only 243MB in use. There are some packages that have been pre-installed, such as blockmount, kernel manager, dynamo DNS, watchcard, UNPN, and etc. Now, let's go to the network interface tab to configure the PPPoE connections on VLAN 35. This is very simple and I have created a detailed guide. You can check out the step-by-step tutorial video with the link in the video description. As you can see, Ethernet 0 will configure as the WAN interface. I will create VLAN 35 interface on this port by entering eth0.35 and hit enter. Now we will need to enter the PPPoE username and password. After that, assign this interface to the WAN firewall zone and hit save. Finally, let's hit save and apply to commit the change. Shortly after that, the PPPoE connection is up and running. Let's run a quick speed test to check it out. Not bad, we are having 366 Mbps download and 219 Mbps for the 200 Mbps internet plan. I will establish the added edge connection to the R5S with PuTTY. I don't know why top were configured in red color and it looked the same with edge top. Never mind, let's run the speed test again and check out the CPU utilization. We can see that the load is only on one core of the CPU. This time, the speed is slower, it is 328 Mbps download and 224 Mbps upload. I will configure the DNS forwarding server and check if the repo is working properly. We can see that it is not working as expected. Something is wrong here. Let's copy the URL and check it out with the browser. Sam, we got error message 404 not found. This could be because the current release candidate version is now RC4. It is not RC2 anymore. Let's change it to RC4 and see if the URL is reachable. Very good, it is working. Let's change the repo URL in system shortware. It looks good now. Let's save the change and update the packet list. Perfect, everything is working as expected and we can install the package now. Let's give a try with htop. Now, let's run the speed test for another time. The total CPU load is 10% for 361 Mbps download and 12% load for 178 Mbps upload. Let's see if the shortwave offloading is enabled. And yes, it was enabled by default. This is something you need to pay attention to if you are about to install QoS. I will turn off shortwave offloading and run the test again. This time, it looks better. The download speed reached 390 Mbps with 33% CPU load. For upload, it is 210 Mbps with 18% CPU utilization. We have a higher CPU utilization and also higher download and upload speed when turning off shortwave offloading. With shortwave offloading enabled, the CPU utilization is low, but the download and upload speed is also low. I'm going to end the video with the IPUB3 test between the routers and my PC. It is a LAN speed test and I expect the throughput will be around 2.3 Gbps. That is all for this video. In the next one, we are going to do more tests with NanoPi R5S. It will be a 1-2 LAN throughput test, OpenVPN and WireGuard VPN, as well as the QoS performance. Of course, I also want to check out the M.2 NVME speed with SMB4, but this will take time and we surely need a separate video for that. Thanks for watching and see you all in the next video. Bye bye.